brethren, we pass in our lives. A few chapters in our story of life with the Lord and the story of Israel brings us these examples that serve to us as a applicant to the church. What was brought to us as a prophecy for us is like a compliment for something that they have passed for the life of church. You remember, yeah, when people got out of Egypt, and Egypt represents the world, and the Pharaoh represents the evil, and what Israel has passed prophetically for us applies in the revelation of for the church. This is a really special moment for Israel, if you remember. God called Hosea when, as when I went with Moses, I will go with you, Hosea. And he stayed firm with the Lord. And the brother, if you guys have the Bible open, in chapter 24, a verse that I think you guys know by mind. Verse 15. Yes. If it seems evil to you to serve the Lord, choose for yourself this day whom you will serve, whether the gods which your fathers served that were on the other side of the river, God of you will serve the Lord. So we have lots of things that the Lord has showed Joshua. First, to fear God and throw away other gods, and last, choose the Lord. So obey the Lord at all times, put the Lord at first place. This is how our life is made us in chapters. Every new moment in our life, he goes, the Lord keeps telling us, but we can't forget the past. We have to, and sometimes we forget. There's a saying, I remember when Jesus touched me. We can't forget the day of our salvation. We can't forget. Sometimes we worry about lots of other things that we forgot to glorify the Lord for that day. So the past can't be forgotten. This chapter, Joshua, it's everything historic from Abraham all the way to Isaac, Jacob, and remembering the people from Israel. And this story we can apply to us as when God first spoke to us. He completes his promises, but we don't forget the promises that were completed in our lives, the cures, the miracles made in our families, parents, sons and daughters. How many signals was made here, Pastor? How many signals have you already done? Sometimes we worry about today, tomorrow, and I forgot to say, oh, I remember the promises that he made us. I remember what you have done. So when Joshua remembers when they left slavery, we have to remember too that today, one day we left slavery of the claws of Satan and went with the Lord. Joshua remembers it, also remembers the present. Verse 13. He remembers because the people of Israel, when they got out, they walked 40 years. Remember? 40 years. After Joshua put the people in the promised land, only when they got there, the city was already, there was already plants there, there was already grapes, those big crates to take when it like bursts. There's a lot of plantations of olives, and God makes them remember this. Verse 13, read with me. But read in the Bible. Read with me. 13. And I have given you a land for which you did not labor. We didn't do anything for our salvation. Jesus worked for us. He died for us. He was resurrected for us. He opened the doors for us. We didn't work for that. The salvation came gratitudely. I gave you land for which you did not labor, and cities which you did not build. The work of God was already made. The work of the church was already done. There is people that already called before us to teach us how to read the Bible, to learn how to glorify the Lord. What more? And you dwell in them. You eat of the vineyards and olive groves which you did not plant. The vineyards, it speaks of the grace of the Lord. Today we hear singing, glorifying the Lord. We didn't do anything, but He did everything for you and for me. The happiness of the Holy Spirit. We didn't do anything for it, but He did it for us. He died. As Jesus died, He said He will reveal His Holy Spirit for us, even today. He's going to be with us until the day of His arrival. And what is the olives? Olive groves. That gives the oil. The thing that saves us from the adversary. That turns on the flame of the Holy Spirit in our hearts. This is what God has done for us. But what has called our attentions today? That this land that we had didn't do anything. He already educated that the church is educated in the Lord Jesus Christ. Even today, we are here. 2,000 years of history. Who held all these chases? Who had sustained the churches through all this? We have learned through Sunday mornings from Apocalypse the churches that were suffered. How many heroes of faith, they failed for the love of the Bible, so that this Bible can reach into us. Today is easy. Before, they used to catch on fire. Today it's on everyone's cell phones. Virtual Bible, there's no way to burn it. But how many died because of the Bible? How many people died because they preserved their faith? And today, brother, we can say, Pastor, that we passed the section 20 and stuff. Lots of us, anyways. The vineyard is ready. Everything's ready. We're only getting the fruits. the city is already built. But the doctrine, the lie, the doctrine, right here. We have to glorify the Lord. Glorify Allah for the Lord because of this. Now there's a detail in these both verses, 26 and 27. Joshua wrote these in the book of God. It's a book that's in eternity. Everything that he did is written on this Bible. Things good and things aren't bad. Our sins, our fails, and what we do for God. One day we're going to be in front of God and we're going to you that were called by God are going to pay for what God has given you to resolve as activity to show you of your talents. Now it's written on the Bible. God has written things glorify and it's written in rocks, not even that, things that can burn. Joshua told him to grab a giant rock, and he grabbed the rock, a big rock, and the New Testament represents Jesus Christ. In the Old Testament too. Because he was doing there, brother. In a place called Sichem. Lots of people are getting here. Getting here from battles when your armies are all wrecked. And a word represents arm. And tonight, indeed, we need to confess our sins and stuff and our fails on the arm of God. We need to glorify the Lord. You can count on me in the future. I'm going to continue being faithful. I'm here this night so that you can renew the blessing of your Holy Spirit in my heart. I want to lay on your shoulders in this city. Abraham made an altar. He had a fight with God. Jacob was the name of Jacob in Arabic means that passes above, that he does everything, every way possible to fix his problem. He takes it as a his. In the arm of God, in the shoulder of God, he changes our hearts. And he goes to Israel, he goes to fight. He's going to fight as a prince. He's a prince with God. A second, he shows that you're a prophet, and in the end, she had a big experience with God. She was on the shoulders of God. Everyone was testimony of what she did, saying that Jesus is now the Savior of the world. Blessed be the name of God. So this night, the Lord is this rock, but see the testament. It was a rock that was an altar underneath a Calvary. The wood speaks of man. Right here with lots of weaknesses, fragile, but this rock on the Calvary was together with the sanctuary of the Lord. Lots of things that the youth needs to run to the feet of God. We have have our fails. The youth has their fails. Us, as our church, has fails. We are wood, fragile. We don't support nothing. But there's a detail. As wood, treated with the oil of the Holy Spirit, we are together at the sanctuary of God. We aren't here in the world. We are here inside the house of the Lord. And He sustains us. Now there's a detail, extraordinary detail. And this rock, it would define the testimony. God is our testimony. He knows when we are right, we are wrong. My blood was poured out for you. The lawyer defends the defendant until the end. And what rock is this? The rock is Jesus. And this rock says, it heard every single word. Jesus is a rock that hears. The rock that is here, hearing your prayers. A voice. I am feeling pain. My soul is sad. You can say it. You can say it really low because you're on the shoulder of God. So this night, Jesus is this rock of hope, a testimony. The text before doesn't say this, but how many references to the rock? Moses, when the people were fighting with Joshua, they asked Moses to put a rock, rest on the rock, and his hands go up. And as his hands are up, as he prays, the Lord gave Israel victory against the people, other people. Yes, go to eternity, and sometimes the answer takes a while to come, but Jesus wants to be your rock. He wants to listen to your prayers. Blessed be the name of the Lord. And the Bible says that Benenzer means rock of hope. Jesus is our rock of hope. People of Israel said, until here, the Lord has helped us. You can say it with me. Until here, the Lord has helped us. Until here, the Lord has helped us. He is this rock that helps. The rock of help that is here this night. Amen. He is a rock that the educators said were wrong. Oh, Jesus is just another leader for us now. While the world rejects, He is the rock where He is a rock of, He's just an old rock to the world. For us, He is a rock angle. It's the angle of the construction that sustains the construction. He is a rock that the church is educated. I will educate my church over this declaration that the Lord is alive. He's educated in the Son of Jesus Christ. And the doors of the world will not be open. Jesus told the parable, rain and winds, nothing will knock your house down, because the rock is here. Jesus is the rock. You may, at this moment, close your eyes. Put your head, your doubts, your confliction, your pain, on the shoulder of God. Tonight that you're going to be able to renew your marriage. I remember the day of my salvation. I remember the day you baptized me with your Holy Spirit. I remember the first time you called me to do something in church. I remember when you cured me. I remember when you brought a family member of mine to church. I remember when the blessing was completed in my life. You glorified the Lord. The rock is hearing. Jesus is present. Glorify the Lord. Glorify the Lord. I invite you to be standing now. Let's have a word of glorification to the Lord. Lots of times the difficulties take us to show everything they've done. For the life of the church here present. Thank you because you cured me. Thank you because you have brought me here. Thank you, Lord, because one more time for your word. That makes me remember who you are, Lord, in my life. We are your people, Lord. That's why right now it's to glorify your name. And there is no other God like you, Lord. Thank you very much for the church today, Lord. Glorify you in the name of Jesus, amen. Glorify be the name of the Lord. We have a few. And one we have in respect of a woman. And this week she had a message really bad. And this left her a lot of difficulties. The sadness, this being worried. But she said, the Lord said tonight that my hands will always be above you, Lord. Even though there's a situation, I am in control. Rest in the Lord. Have faith in the Lord, He can do all things. Until here, the Lord has sustained us. This is our message, our testimony. It's what the Lord has done for our lives. And what the Lord said. We came back from a battle, and our armor was everything was bad, and all the difficulties, but the Lord has given us the victory. Church of the Lord, they walk victory, because we are the people of the Lord. We pray and we win everything in glorification, having faith in the Lord. Let's close our eyes and pray. Lord, we glorify your name, Lord, for one more night we are here in your presence, Lord. We thank you, Lord, for this day, where we can hear your voice and hear your teaching that lots have spoken to our hearts. We are happy, Lord, because until here, there is this nothingness. There wasn't a moment where your hands were above us, Lord, taking us to be in your presence, Lord. Receive our gratitude, our song, in the name of Jesus, amen. In your name, Jesus, Lord, in the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, eternal Father, may be poured upon all of us, for now and forever, amen. You may be seated. Start here if you want a prayer. We are here, and right after at 9 p.m. we're gonna have a vigil with the youth. If the parents want to stay, everyone's invited. Amen. Peace to the Lord.